was on Apollo. I've been trying to pave the way, but they didn't tell me it was potos. America ain't dreaming, they been skimming when the. We all know it's black, black genius. Everybody love the culture, they be black by convenience. Sounded like a real anthem. Charlie saw my wallet, now she's bigger answer. Whoa, telling me she.
It's time to meet the starting five for your Washington Wizards. The man in the middle, 6'10", number 21, Daniel Gafford. Starting at small forward, 6'9", starting at shooting guard, 6'4", number 13, Jordan Poole. The other guard, 6'1", number 5, Tyus.
Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for this NBA presentation. Tonight, it'll be the Washington Wizards going up against the Los Angeles Clippers. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Brent Barry. From the sideline, we'll have David Aldridge. We'll be hearing from him in just a moment. Looking now at some numbers for Terrence Mann.
And guys, I think the best way to measure his performance these last 10 games is his effective field goal percentage, which has improved, and a sign that his game is in much better shape than it was not too long ago.
Here are the five for the Clippers. Mann in at shooting guard with George at small forward. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Plumlee, and it's Harden in at the point. And for the Wizards, in the backcourt, it's Jones and Poole. In at the forward positions, Avdija and Kuzma. And it's Gafford in at the five down. And at this point of the year, Greg, injuries starting to mount for some teams.
And this is where your depth gets tested, your resolve. Because it takes a strength in numbers and strong leadership to get through it.
Basket counts. Avdija's got the opening bucket of the night here for Washington. Harden against Jones. Plumlee with a screen on Jones. Harden against Jones. And here's Avdija. He kicks to Jones. Kuzma outside. Back to Jones. Five on the clock. Down low. Kuzma can't get it to go. On offense, here are the Clippers. We play just over a minute here in the first. Pass to Leonard. Shoots over Kuzma. And it's Leonard. That time on the assist by George.
What a nice attribute to have with your wing player being able to operate and control the offense. That's what PG can do.
Pass to Gafford. Wizards passing it around. Poole bounce pass. Gafford misses.
For him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Leonard looking over the floor. And he uses the glass on the way. Leonard's got his second bucket of the night.
Working some magic inside. Leonard so polished.
Just about 2 minutes into the game. First quarter of basketball. Now, here's Poole. He's covered closely. Offensive rebound. Kicks it out to Jones. Now the pass to Poole. The three. It's hauled in by the Clippers.
still searching out their offensive game right now. 1 of 5 from the field to start this one.
And Brent, an interesting aspect of Mason Plumlee's game is his passing.
Yeah, good coaches, Greg, have found a way to put Mason Plumlee in positions to succeed as a passer. You don't see that much with big men in the NBA, but he's capable.
Now, Avdija, James Harden missing on the three. Kuzma with the screen for Jones. Passes it to Gafford. And that comes off the assist by Jones.
And this is the attack mindset you want to see coming into the game.
Tone setting right here early. Love that tenacity.
Now here's Harden. 11-point game, his last outing. Outside, George. Plumlee sets the pick for George. No good from outside.
Not quite enough defense. That time around, just lucky he was off.
Poole finds Gafford. Pass to Poole. Three-pointer. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
And Poole is such a tough and dynamic three-point shooter. He's comfortable firing from anywhere.
Harden against Jones. Here's George. Rebounded by Gafford.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Pass to Jones. Rebound by the Clippers. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Wizards team.
And last season, they made short work of this club. 2 games, 2 wins.
Sort of representative of how they each finished the season. One a playoff team, the other on the outside looking in. I think things may play out the same way this year, too.
And here is Gafford. After Paul George getting his three to go, Gafford kicks to Kuzma. From the arc. Unable to get that one.
He really suffocated him there, guys. Just excellent work.
Harden against Jones. Entered on the wing. From past the arc. It's good. The assist that time from Harden.
3 points.
Leonard's got 7 points.
Nice teamwork. The right guy ends up with the ball in his hands. And Kawhi finishes that possession.
Near the three-point line, it's Poole. That's it. He's got 2 made now, and he's shooting 2 for 3.
This is a solid opening quarter right here. Very active and creating a lot of good opportunities for himself.
Kuzma against Leonard. That one goes in for him, too, making it look easy. He's now 4 for 4.
Well, he hasn't missed yet, guys, and the defense is scrambling for answers to stop this hot start.
Up top, Kuzma. Now, here's Poole. He's tightly guarded. Jones with the screen on Leonard. Kuzma inside. He's covered by Leonard. That one's not going to go. George looking over the floor. Harden, no good. And it's Jones with the ball for the Wizards. They trail by 3. Avdija, the pass to Jones. Gafford sets the pick for Jones. Now on the scoring column with that bucket. 1 for 2 this game. Clippers have gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. Harden against Jones. And the foul called on Tyus Jones.
Tyus Jones.
That's his first foul.
First personal foul.
Kispert's checked in for Kyle Kuzma. And the Clippers with a change here, too. Russell Westbrook's checked in for George. Plumlee, the pass to Mann. Stolen away. Now, here's Avdija. He's guarded closely. The Clippers in the lead. The past few seasons have seen frequent shakeups to the Wizards roster.
Yeah, the Wizards have been a bit of a lab in terms of trying to figure out what exactly is that they're going to have that works. What's the recipe here? What's the perfect fit here? And I'm sure in time it's going to come together.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
James Harden taking two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. And load management, a term, Greg, that's been associated with the Clippers.
And Kawhi rightfully managing his return from ACL injury with care. It's harder to build chemistry when guys are out, but it's all about staying healthy for the postseason.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Daniel Tice comes in for Mason Plumlee. And Norman Powell subbed in for Terrence Mann.
They hold the early advantage on the glass.
Harden kicks to Leonard. Harden sets the pick for Leonard. And the three ball is good. Leonard's got a pair of threes now in the first quarter for the Clippers.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Gafford passes to Kispert. Tipped away. It's stolen by Tice. Right against Westbrook. And Harden now, top of the key. And the layup falls.
James Harden.
And now it's an 8-point Los Angeles lead.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Gafford against Tice. And it's Kispert in the corner. Six on the shot clock. And there's the pass to Wright. Over Westbrook. And again, Washington, no good. Los Angeles leading by eight. 125 left to play in the first quarter. Here's Leonard. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. Washington's gone 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. That's good from Poole on the assist by Wright. Poole's got seven.
Whew, highlight reel stuff there from Jordan Poole.
Up top Tice. There's 57 seconds left to play in the first. Tice with a screen on Poole. Harden finds Tice. Leonard, that's for two. Washington with the rebound. Gafford's got six rebounds here tonight.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Harden against Poole. Gafford is screen on Harden. The three from Poole gets the three-pointer to fall. And now just a three-point Clipper lead. Westbrook, nothing on the board. Passes to Leonard. That one doesn't go. Kawhi Leonard has been on display for the LA Clippers. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. And don't go away. We'll be right back. Getting going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Clippers?
Coming in hot. They were sharp from the perimeter right out of the gate.
They just couldn't seem to know what it was that they needed to do and how to stick them from outside. The defense pretty lost.
So with Harden on the bench, here's who Teron Lewis going with. Out on the wings for him, Powell and George. Daniel Tice out there with P.J. Tucker. And it's Westbrook in at the one. Hey, Brent, with his skill set, Norman Powell is the type of player that could fit on any team.
Yeah, so effective at playing off the ball, and he's a good source of instant offense when he gets that opportunity. He could be a three-level scorer.
Now here's Wright to the left side wing. Rulabali, a three-pointer is right on target. Rulabali's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Powell with it. Scoreless thus far. Bagley with the rebound.
He's got so many ways to score in the post. Just nifty, uses fakes. Have to have a body on him every time he's down there.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Los Angeles.
They've looked to fire as much as possible from outside the arc, and so far, they are hitting at a high clip.
So much good energy and flow tonight, and that has really come out of great ball movement. Guys have been open, and as soon as they are, they get the ball.
That one drops. He ties it up. And the classic, the bank shot. Very popular at one time. What happened to it?
I think the only time you really see it, Kevin, is when guys are going in for layups at full speed and trying to take some of that speed off the basketball. But guys really just don't get the ball in possession where they're going to use a good angle off the glass. Those are usually mid-range shots. How many of those do you see?
Now, Wright, after Norman Powell missed from long range. Pass to Bagley. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession. Now that we have a second, let's take a quick peek at the rebounding numbers for the last handful of seasons for Russell Westbrook.
It's a concerning trend. Whether he's lost some strength or just isn't putting in as much effort on the glass as he used to, he's not rebounding nearly as effectively anymore. And that's something that needs to change.
Diaz checked in for Washington. Jones comes in for Wright. Outside, George. Three-pointers off the mark.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Kuzma against Tice. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead bucket. And here's Westbrook. He'll bring it up for the Clippers. Tough loss coming against Cleveland in their last game play.
Poor execution in that one. Not sure what led to the lack of focus, but coaching staff definitely not happy.
And they made some comments themselves that some of the fault might have lied with them because they didn't go in with the best of game plans and they didn't make the right adjustments. So we'll see tonight if they do.
And here's Avdija after Paul George getting his three to go. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
The length and the athleticism combination of Paul George is very hard to guard.
One thing you marvel at, the consistency of Paul George year in and year out.
I wonder when Paul George, Greg, goes into the offseason, if it's more tinkering and sharpening all those skills, or if he's trying to add something, because I don't know how you add anything to how versatile a player he is.
Mason Plumlee's checked in for the Clippers. James Harden comes in for Norman Powell. Gispert, no good.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
Here's Westbrook. No good on the shot, a bit long that time. Wizards trail by five. Gispert kicks to Jones. Kuzma outside. And Kuzma slams it in.
And you just got to find some space. Kuzma with a nice cut and then not holding back.
Harden the pass to George. Harden sets the pick for George. Hits the three-point bomb. George has got a couple of three-pointers in the second for the Clippers.
That's number two for him from long range in the quarter. His third overall.
Pass to Avdija. Back to Jones. From down in the low post, it goes.
Just the late reaction there from the defense, and he is always going to finish that one.
Harden outside. The teardrop falls in. Harden's got six.
And that touch Harden has, making the floater look so effortless coming off his fingertips.
Here's Jones. It drops for his third basket. He's missed only one shot.
Oh, such a feel shot there, the floater.
The three from Harden. Rebound, Washington. He'll be playing host to Miami for the next game. That'll be the second of four games at home for him. Kispert with it, working on Plumlee, and the wide-open shot from Avdija. Traps in the tray. Now just a one-point Clipper lead.
He just sagged off just enough and no hesitation on his part.
Here's the pass to George. It's over Avdija, and Jones pulls it down.
If you told me this was the kind of game he was going to have, I would not have expected them to be in front right now.
Kispert with the bucket.
What a feed for Kuzma. I like it when he finds the open man, and so do they.
L.A. has gotten half their shots from three-point range to go down in the second quarter. Three of six from downtown. For three, Westbrook. Kuzma pulls it in. So for the Wizards, their last game, a win against the Spurs.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
That never stopped working. One of those games where just everybody was making shots, continual flow, and a very professional win.
Washington making some changes. Daniel Gafford's checked in for Corey Kispert. And Poole subbed in for Kyle Kuzma. And then for Los Angeles, Kawhi Leonard comes in for P.J. Tucker. Mann subbed in for Russell Westbrook. Clippers trail by four. Now, here is Harden. 6 points for him. Leonard on the wing. Shoots over Avdija. And it's Leonard. That time on the assist from Harden. Harden's got his third assist on the night. And the Wizards with possession. Greg, it seems like the Wizards have been trying to find their edge against tough teams.
Yeah, and the first question is, which end does it happen on, offense or defense? Because you can win tough games by being great at either.
And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. Second, that is his first foul of the game. Russell Westbrook checked in for George.
Zero. Russell Westbrook.
Avdija, 9 points last game out. Pass to Poole. Shot clock at five. No good with the triple. L.A. has gone past the three-point line for 13 of their shots. 6 of 13 to the inside. And it's slammed in by Plumlee.
Assisted.
Yeah, no more can we talk about underrated jumping ability from the Plumlees. Suddenly he's up and attacking the rim.
Pass to Gafford. And here is Poole. Gafford is screen on Harden. Poole finds Jones. The kick out to Poole. From downtown, Russell Westbrook with the rebound.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Inside, Plumlee shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two. Plumlee's got his second bucket of the game to go. And it's Jones with the ball for Washington, trailing by two. To Koulibaly. Nice ball movement by Washington. Poole with no one around. Again, the miss by Poole.
He's cooled down a little bit after draining those 2 3-pointers in the first quarter.
Westbrook dishes to Harden. Shoots over Poole. And again, the Clippers good for two.
Yeah, that first quarter was a bit shaky. Good to see a player who doesn't let a slow start get to him.
Pass to Gafford. Poole kicks to Avdija. And the pass to Gafford. There's the dish to Avdija.
2 minutes.
It's Jones on the way. Over Westbrook. almost, but it rolls out.
And that was almost a block. Still did enough to alter the shot.
Yeah, altering the shot, just as long as there's a miss, that kind of energy not wasted.
And now the latest from our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thank you, guys. Well, Kyle Kuzma has always been a crazy confident person. He said, "I've always had this incredible self-belief that no matter who I'm on the court with, I'm the best player. And that's gotten me to this level. That's gotten me to where I am. So my irrational confidence has always been a key thing for me." Kevin, back to you.
Really owns it, David. I like that. Thanks. Harden, no good. Washington's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. On the wing, Jones. He's covered by Westbrook. On the basket by Jones.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
LA's gone for the three-pointer 7 times here in the second and been successful 3 times. Outside Westbrook. 41 seconds left in the first half. He's off on that one. Good D by Jones.
Maybe a time to rest him right now. Just give him a bit of a breather. Try to help him get back on track.
Screen by Jones. Here's Poole. And Washington again with the bucket.
Yeah, I don't think that's at the top of the menu of shots that Jordan Poole likes to take, but he can knock it down with touch.
Harden against Poole. Harden scanning the floor. Passes it to Leonard. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Wizards lead by 2. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Coach Tyronn Lue. Coach, what is the focus going to be in the second half?
Just play the right way. Move the ball, share the ball, get stops, and get out and run the transition.
Always leads to good results. Thanks, Tyronn. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
Welcome, everybody. The Washington Wizards in our featured matchup, and what a competitive half it's been.
Shaq, this reminds me of our day. They're not just hoisting up 1,000 threes. They're dumping the ball inside to the paint and then going up strong. I love it.
Me too, Kenny. I hope they win like this. I really do.
And moving on, let's take a peek at how the East is shaping up here in the midseason.
When I look at the Wizards, they knew it was going to be a tough year, and I got to say, it's been hard to watch them fight, looking through all these challenges. I hope they're learning something out there, challenging times for the franchise.
That'll do it for our show tonight. Thanks for joining us, and we'll send you back to Kevin Harlan for more Hoops action.
after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. Kawhi Leonard really has his fingerprints all over this one.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. And at the forward positions, Avdija and Kuzma. In the backcourt, it's Jones and Poole. And it's Gafford in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the group on the floor right now for Washington. And that one's good, Leonard.
And Leonard, a three-level scorer as well as an offensive anchor for this team.
A two-time finals MVP, Kawhi Leonard. Brent, he's shown he can dominate at the highest of levels.
And when he dominates every facet of the game. At his peak, Kawhi is one of the most impactful players this game has ever seen.
Basket, good. Kuzma's got 7 points.
Kuzma, rise and fire.
And it's Harden with the ball for Los Angeles. From 11 feet away, good on the bucket. Harden's got the game tied up here for the Clippers.
And that's what makes Harden so tough to contain. He can hurt you at all three levels and gets them from the mid-range on that one.
Now here's Jones. He's got 10. Poole kicks to Kuzma. Gafford sets the pick for Kuzma. At three off the mark. Los Angeles has gone past the three-point line for 13 of their shots. 6 of 13. Mann passes to Harden. George with the ball. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got 4 assists in the game.
And George, a volume three-point shooter, he possesses outstanding confidence and leans into that perimeter game.
Now, here's Poole. He's got 12. The shot's good from Gafford.
And defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Outside Leonard. Over Jones. And it's Leonard missing.
Yeah, but they're 3 of 4 to start the second half.
Pass to Jones. Kuzma outside. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Man, Greg, it just seems like every night Kyle Kuzma is going to put up double digits.
And he has the potential to be a double-double threat. Just needs to get more aggressive on the glass. And recently, I mean, we've seen Kyle Kuzma turn things around, especially offensively.
Yeah, Greg, highs and lows in the early part of Kyle Kuzma's career, but a nice settled ground for him. Offensively, he's carried more responsibility and shown that he's capable of doing it.
Harden, that's good. Harden's got 12 points in the game.
And when Harden's this close, he looks to score. Love his mentality.
Pass to Gafford. Feeds to Avdija. A second chance effort. He takes it up and lays it in. 9 points in the game so far. A great competitive game so far.
And from the look of it, this one could go right down to the wire.
To the wing on the left. Takes the three. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
If Leonard doesn't like his options to score the ball offensively first, he'll play with the ball a little bit.
Now, here's Avdija, defended by George. Gafford kicks to Kuzma. And it's Paul George with the foul.
Paul,
that's his first foul.
First personal foul. Second team foul.
Left to the wing. And there's the whistle. Illegal screen.
And let's take a look at Kyle Kuzma's numbers. A wonderful string of games he's put together here lately. And don't forget, top 20 in the league in rebounds per game. He's got a great nose for the ball.
And his shooting form at the line has been outstanding. Economical release. Fully extends on the follow-through. He can close games for you. Now here's Harden. He's got 12. Leonard draws the double. From deep, George. And another three for the Clippers.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
So timeout call here. The first for Washington.
It's teaser time.
Check out the Eastern Conference standings now that we're in the new year. Taking a look at Washington, down to the bottom of the conference, their fans hope they can turn it around and show some improvement.
Make some noise!
Here's Jones, 10 points for him. A pass to Gafford. Kuzma against Leonard. Kuzma passes to Gafford. Yep, that one goes. Gafford's got six.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Jones against Harden. George with a screen on Jones. Here's Harden on the wing. He has been a nice option for them offensively and is averaging more than 17 points a game. Wizards trail by three. And taking a look at the LA Clippers, Brent, a team that just keeps coming up short, unfortunately.
Well, the Clippers have definitely been more competitive lately, and it's kind of like phase two for them with this group. They still haven't been able to get over the hump, and they have some work to do.
And the Clippers making a change here. Westbrook's checked in.
A big fella with the ability and confidence at the free throw line is something that every team wants. Don't have to make those late substitutions. Keep your big guys on the floor.
Now, here's Avdija. He's got 11. Out to Kuzma. Shot clock at 6. Over Westbrook. The shot's good from Kuzma. 11 points in the game.
Getting exactly what he wants. Kuzma just needing to create some elbow room for himself.
To the middle. Here's Westbrook. And Jones pulls it down. The Wizards with the lead. Gafford sets the pick for Jones. And it's James Harden with the rebound. And so it's Harden bringing it up for the Clippers. They've got the Pistons ahead of them in their next game in Detroit. Russell, just the fifth of this long seven-game road trip.
Well, Russell James looking Harden to shoot as soon as he's in attack mode.
Passes it to Gafford. Kuzma outside. Outside, Jones. Let's it go from 11. Kuzma can't get it to go. Los Angeles has gotten the three ball working for them in the second half. They've hit three out of three shots from long range. George finds Harden. Pass to Leonard. Shoots over Gafford. Sweet move. Rebounded by Gafford. Gafford's got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Outside, Jones. Screen by Jones. Near the three-point line, it's Poole. The Wizards with another miss.
Probably not the shot that was drawn up for that possession, but you can't pass it up, and you can't knock it down.
Poole against Leonard. Fires from deep. Rebound by the Wizards.
Yeah, the defense there in chill mode. We all know he can burn them from three-point range.
Kuzma outside. Kicks to Avdija. There's the three. Plumlee with the rebound. Plumlee's got 7 rebounds in the game. And it's Leonard. That time on the assist by George.
Assist goes to
18 points for Leonard.
Kawhi like a robot out there just shrugging off the contact. Beep, boop,
pop, pop. Washington calls timeout. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up. And with Marvin Bagley III, Brent, it just feels like he's been snake bitten in his young career.
Yeah, but Greg, you know this. If you can hang in there and stay confident, get a second chance. And with that second chance, maybe this opportunity for Marvin Bagley is going to be the one where we can show that talent. Remember, second overall pick back in 2018.
The first free throw is good.
And the game Bagley has reminds me a little bit of Chris Bosh, a sweet lefty who plays with force and passion.
And the Clippers, one of the more efficient three-point shooting teams, Greg, in the NBA.
And Kevin, really over the last decade, that's been one of their most consistent traits. And it's not just because of talent, they're smart about the shots they take.
Now, here's Tice. Good! Leonard's got six here in this quarter.
And a little BUMP, Leonard says, that doesn't bother me whatsoever. So poised.
Poole against Highland. The kick out to Wright. To the paint. And Koulibaly gets it to go. Koulibaly's got his second basket of the night.
And then you gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind it out game.
Right outside. Pass to Kispert. Here's Poole for the lead. And it's Bagley getting it to go. And the Wizards lead by one.
And Poole's vision developing right in front of us.
Westbrook feeling it out a bit. Let's it go with a three. It's rebounded by Koulibaly. Washington's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. The pass to Poole. 40 seconds left to play in the third. And it's in there. And now it's a three-point Wizards lead.
And he's absolutely feeling it. There is no hesitation from Jordan Poole.
Outside Leonard. Now here's Powell. Defense is right there. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. Passes it to Poole. Is flushed down with a nice jam.
Using those hops to attack the rim. Poole takes flight.
And here's Leonard to end the run. And that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in. The third quarter comes to a close. Wizards out front, leading by five. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. And let's take now this moment to bring up our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feat.
The coaches talk about it all the time, but to be able to play with that kind of feel, nice play, collaborating, improvising, and organic.
Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. So with Leonard on the bench, here's who Teron Lewis going with. Out on the wings for him, Powell and George. E.J. Tucker is out there with Daniel Tice, and it's Westbrook in at the point. Here's Wright, Paul George making his last shot for the three, and that one's good. Wright. Wright's got the lead up to six now for the Wizards.
He's going to punish you if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
Westbrook passes to George. That's good, and so Westbrook comes up with the assist. Westbrook's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Wright looking around. We've played just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter. Nice ball movement by Washington. It's Kuzma penetrating. Bagley with a wide open look. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. It's George on the wing. And they're unable to get the tying basket there. Washington leading now by three. Pass to Wright. Bagley with a screen on Westbrook. And Wright kicks to Bagley. A three-pointer, no good. And here's Westbrook. He'll bring it up for the Clippers. They've played a great fourth quarter defensively, allowing only 3 points. On the wing, George. Clock at six. He watches it go through the hoop for his eighth make. Now 8 for 14.
Man, he is just really in a flow right now. That field goal percentage has gone through the roof.
Kispert, the pass to Kuzma. To the left wing, pass to Koulibaly. Right inside. He's covered by Westbrook. Bagley, and finished off by Bagley.
Bagley committed to do something on that possession offensively, playing aggressive.
Wizards making a switch here. Gafford's checked in. James Harden, he's checked in for the Clippers.
And they're drawing more whistles and working their way to the line here in the second half.
Pass to George. Whistle blows. That's going to be a travel.
And he's done a good job of keeping control of the ball. Even with that turnover, you can tell his teammates trust him to hang on to the pill.
Corey Kispert's checked in for Washington. Washington leading now by four. The pass to Gafford. Now here's Wright. Kuzma passes to Gafford. Back to Kuzma. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Daniel Tice. That'll be his third foul so far.
Second team foul.
And just about 3 minutes through the fourth quarter here. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's going to be on James Harden. So GA, the Wizards with their trades over the summer. They have definitely hit the reset button for a rebuild.
Yeah, and moved on from Beal and traded Porzingis as well. So kept Kuzma and brought in Poole to start the youth movement. Exciting times for the Wizards.
Well, a great player on a great role at the charity stripe. The D has got to be careful about being too aggressive on him and sending him back for freebies.
Oh, and the rejection by Gafford. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. Wright dishes to Kispert. Passes it to Kuzma. Down to five on the shot clock. And another miss by Washington. Clippers trail by six. Now George. And the rejection by Gafford. And they get it back. Lets it go from deep. And there's Paul George on the assist from Tucker. George has got a pair of threes here in the fourth quarter for Los Angeles. Harden against Wright. Excellent D there from George.
Defense is tough as it comes right there. He's a hard man to deny when he gets the ball to the rim.
Powell sends a screen for Harden. And DeLon Wright gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul for the Clippers. Plumlee is checked in for Daniel Tice. Leonard comes in for P.J. Tucker. And Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Norman Powell. Harden against Poole. Plumlee with a screen on Poole. Six to shoot. The Clippers need to get off a shot. And it's Westbrook missing.
Well, if he wants to make the defense work, he's got to start knocking down the threes. Only one so far in this game for him, and none since halftime.
Now, here's Kuzma. Dishes it to Avdija. Poole against Harden, and Poole gets it to go.
Those are two tough points from Poole. Great to see him mixing it up down low.
Kuzma against Leonard. Here's Plumlee. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
And the team not really doing its job there. A little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint.
Mans checked in for Russell Westbrook. That's good from Plumlee. Here's Jones. Washington calls timeout.
On the floor. Wizards timeout.
Guard it.
Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Well, during the break, I listened in to what the head coach of the Wizards was getting across in the huddle. He said to them, that's the kind of effort we need to bring every night. We're right in this thing, but it's going to take sustained effort to close it out. Now let's bring it home. Kevin, back to you.
All right, thank you, David. And so it's Washington with it. A two-point game. Cool with it. Buries it down low. Cool's got 20 points.
He's got a lot to do with the position that they're in. A very smart offensive performance tonight from him.
Here's Leonard. Rebound, Washington. Gafford's got rebound number 13 for him here tonight. And Poole gets it to go.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, that's going to draw a whistle every time down the floor. Not even close to being a legal screen.
Yeah, everybody saw that one. That was pretty blatant there.
Getting another opportunity here to see that powerful rejection.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
And their offense is really clicking right now.
Playing with a lot of energy and really taking it to the defense.
And Jones gets it to go in on the assist from Poole. And it's an 8-point Wizards lead. Leonard against Kuzma. Leonard kicks to Harden. And the Clippers miss again. Wizards have gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. Pass to Gafford. And here is Poole. Gafford sets the pick for Poole. Connects from three-point range. Poole's got the lead up to 11 now for the Wizards.
Yeah, you would think a coach might have talked to his defense about making the adjustment on him, but right now, he's just lighting him up.
Harden gets the bucket.
Yeah, you got your shooters and you have your scorers, but James Harden is both.
Pass to Gafford. Back to Jones. And there's the foul. It'll go on Terrence Mann. And that'll be his third foul so far.
Fourth team foul.
Now here's Jones. Kuzma outside.
And that's number four. Definitely something to keep track of as we move forward.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Wizards.
You love how they've lived in the paint, making the defense just consistently have to collapse and still finding ways to convert.
We probably have to touch on as well that tonight their penetration has been awesome. I mean, they put force on this game, attacking off the bounce, and the willingness to do that has paid off.
Now, here's George. Here's Plumlee, and finished off by Plumlee.
That's the man you want running into the pick and roll. It's Paul George at the helm. He's got the ball and makes a great play.
And on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam, you can see how impressive that move was.
Timeout.
Washington calls timeout.
Whether things are good, bad, or indifferent, coaches will have adjustments to make throughout the course of the game.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
Let's give it up one more time for your Wizards dancer. It's time to make some noise.
Kuzma against Leonard. Gafford inside. Abdia, shot clock at 6. Nice ball movement by Washington.
2 minutes.
And 10 shot. Kuzma can't get it to go.
He's not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far just not himself in the second half.
Harden the pass to Plumlee. And here's George. Over Abdia. George, no good. If they want to, they can milk the clock just a little bit here.
Yeah, that's the best option.
Kuzma outside. Poole with it, and it's Harden picking him up. Gafford kicks to Abdia. The pass to Poole. For the screen on Harden. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession. Here's George. 1:14 left in the fourth quarter. From 18 feet away. And the bucket is good. 3-point play chance here for him.
And you can feel it from the second the ball landed in Plumlee's hands that he had his eyes on the rim. Huge basket there.
That's good from Plumlee. 1:06 left in the fourth quarter. Kuzma against Leonard. And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot 2.
At the line for Washington.
Kyle Kuzma. 2 shots.
He drops the first one, and that puts them up by 5.
There's all these little attributes to Kyle Kuzma's game that you start to see show themselves. He's developing as a passer and as a rebounder. I think his best basketball is still ahead of him. Some padding here on the free throw line. Some good work.
Now, here is George. It's over Abdia. Got it. And now they trail by just 4.
Yeah, Paul George sharpening his swords now. Love to see him take that shot.
On the wing, Jones, guarded by Harden. Here's Kuzma. The Wizards with another miss.
And there hasn't been anything easy for him in this period.
No, I haven't seen him in comfortable spots, or at least spots we've seen in this offensive set where they're allowing him to settle in.
Now, here is Harden. Following the miss by Kyle Kuzma. Plumlee sets the pick for Harden. Just 5 to shoot, and no good that time. And an intentional foul there stops the clock.
Mason, yeah, you can't let him hold first the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
Gets the first, and that puts them up by 5. So it gets them both, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Ooh, I think that's a wrap. And I can tell you, you can't have more pressure-packed free throws than the ones that are going to seal the game.
And the Clippers call time here. They trail by 6. 12 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's what's your take?
Still a sliver of hope.
Yeah, act fast, but without mistakes.
Your Wizards dancer.
From deep, George. Kuzma pulls it in. And that's an intentional foul.
Third personal foul. At the line for the Wizards.
And the first of two, no good. Heartbreaker.
Kuzma. Two shots.
That's good. Going one of two from the line. And that makes it a seven-point lead. And the Clippers call time here. They're down by seven. 9 seconds left to play in the final quarter. What's your take, guys?
Trying to keep hope alive, but I don't see them making a comeback.
Yeah, this is the classic too little, too late. The effort coming and not enough time for them to get back in it.
The three from George knocks down the trifecta.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Pretty infectious right here, guys. In good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Jordan Poole.
Good on the first, and that puts them up by five.
And Jordan Poole has stepped onto the NBA stage and not ever backed down from the challenge. He plays with tremendous confidence.
And Leonard puts it up from deep three. No good. And so it's the Wizards with the W. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans, but in the end, everyone satisfied.
Yeah, I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted, and especially early on, but let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Guys, thanks. Kyle Kuzma, congrats on the win. What were you able to do successfully tonight?
I think as a team collectively, we just got stops and kind of found a rhythm, offense, and you know we got it done like that.
Well, that rhythm led to a W, man. Congrats. Back to you.
Thanks so much, David. And that'll do it, folks. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us as we end with the New Balance Player of the Game.